JT in space.
For one priceless moment,
JT in space.
In the whole history of man, all the people on this earth are truly one.
JT in space.
I believe that this nation should commit itself to achieving the goal.
JT in space.
Of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the earth.
Goodness, they are the escapiest Moses. No, Melody, don't. Hi, I hope you're doing well. Sorry about being late today. I had some stuff I needed to take care of. Basically, we have this thing in our city or town where you can buy stuff directly from local producers. So like eggs and yams and stuff that they make instead of buying them in a supermarket. So we do that every second Tuesday or whatever. So I went there to pick up some stuff because it's at 6 o'clock where my stream begins. Derp. Hello, Lino. I'm pretty sure you've been here before, but welcome. It's so nice to see you all. Local producer markets are the best. Yes, I agree.
That's great music. I loved it.
Harmony, are you going to stop being a super shy and nervous moose and come out and say hi? Farmer's market. Yeah, it's kind of that. I guess. So, she, who just she's who's over there. She's the escapist of Mises. Don't run away. And for anyone joining this chat, this is not actually the cage that I usually have them in. This is an introduction cage, also called a boring box. The idea is that they have nothing in here to basically be territorial about, and they're forced to interact with each other in close proximity. So the point is that these mice are going to get to know each other, so that they don't fight and become obnoxious when I put them in a bigger cage, which is the one over there. Also, Moo, you just escaped the box. Come back here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come, come. Don't. There you go. Like I said, the escapist Moses. Oh, you too, Havoc? You too? No. Thank you. Yeah, this is the life of having mice. They escape constantly, so keep an eye on them. She looks so hilariously small now that the others are in the big cage. Anyway, we're going to do some work today. So, I'm gonna see if I can make World Anvil cooperate with me this day. It never cooperates because it's just, you know, OBS being OBS, I guess. Where is it? Am I blind? I am blind. There it is. Aha! Located! Where are you going? Do you want to go back to the cage? So go that way. Other direction, Mo. Mo. Other direction. The other arm. Yes, that arm. Keep going. Keep going. Okay, fine. Stay on my shoulder then. You're gonna be that way. That's what we have in the States anyway. Local producers sell their goods. My town has a lot of fishing, lavender, honey, and some other farm goods, and they come to sell in an open air market space like every other Saturday. Okay. Well, yeah, that is pretty much what we have here. Yeah. So I guess it's a farmer's market. Goblin, go back to the cage. Moose. Nope. Indeed. He's exploring Moosey. Well, she does like this one though, so. If she wants to be here, I guess I'll offer her space to be. Because she does like this. This cozy hoodie. Let's put it on and let her live in this one. You coming? There you are. Okay, so you're gonna be under the hoodie now. All right, whatever. Moose being moose, I guess. Everyone get your cult robe hoods up. The sermon begins with moose. Exactly, that's what happens, I think. Anyway, I just managed to fix the thing, so, haha. And now that I think about it, actually, don't I have something for this? You. Ta-da! Moose cam. Okay, so I have no idea what I was supposed to do today, because this entire day has been kind of thrown off of the everything. So what I'm going to do is check my to-do list. Because the to-do list is my life. Right, we were gonna work on that. Only in our farmer's market, they're literally selling stuff out of the trunk of their car, and they have to, and you have to put in an order well in advance, and the market only lasts for 30 minutes. Yeah, pretty much. It's you order via a marketplace online, and they bring it there, and you just pick it up. So it's not like you browse around. It's you have already ordered, and you go there, pay, and pick your stuff up. Do we have anything here? I think Moo is trying to get up through the hood, through my... Melody? Could you please? Ours is an all-morning event. Ah, okay. Yeah, it's just a car. Usually relatively large cars, like station wagons and stuff. By American standards, that's not big. But by Swedish standards, those cars are big. And they just open the back of their car and they just have all the stuff there. Okay. Moose! You're being obnoxious right now. Do you know that? Yeah, come up here. Come up here. Yeah, so now you are on the right side of the hoodie. Thank you. Yeah, you and everyone else seems to be playing Valheim, and I just look at it and I'm like, who the hell has time to play that? It's like, I wish I had spare time, but I don't. I'm trying to avoid doing what I need to do. That's kind of what the problem is. I'm still angry about Polish bookstores which categorize D&Ds as toys for boys. That was interesting. Valheim, it is not necessarily a multiplayer game, but it can be. It's very much like Don't Starve. Oh god, well I guess we're gonna have to do that then. Fine. I guess we are going to do some actual game design for once. Don't do that always. Don't starve. Now don't starve, excuse my poor English. Lorraine, why do you always do this? Why do you leave two comments on your own things? I don't understand. Swinglish is where it's at. Exactly. I'm not a big fan of Nordic stuff, so Valheim gets a hard no for me.
I think I need to ban you now.
That is a lot of likes. What is this? Oh, it's just all from Dimitris. I have a thing where I save all of Dimitris's likes and interactions with my stuff. So that's why I have them. No, I'm not gonna ban you, I'm just kidding. It's obviously not to everyone's taste, but me being Scandinavian, I kinda have to like it. But I do like it when it's well done, when it's like they at least did their minimal research on like myths and culture and nature, which a lot of games don't do. God of War, for instance. Though granted, God of War was basically Norse fantasy, so it doesn't count. Except when it's Danish. Yeah. All right. So, we need to fix, it's in characters. So we need to fix that. In one of my worlds, the Aesir are the guardians of the multiverse. So, the MCU. Because that's literally what the Asgardians do there. Though they call them the Asgardians, not the Aesir. But still. Where is that? Should be right about here. Yes, it is. So there's a block here somewhere. There it is. 46351. Fill the blocks. Valheim could be a great educational game for kids about the Nordic history, Stone Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age. Interesting. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Basically, the market is oversaturated with Nordic stuff. Yeah. It is, and a lot of it is rather nonsensical. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love my Thor and Avengers, especially Thor Ragnarok, because it's just amazing. But is it really Norse, though? Nah, I'd call it fantasy. It has very little to do with actual Norse. Slavic is just wild. I looked into it briefly on occasion and it's just... what? I like it. It's not as crazy as Japanese, but it is pretty crazy. Are you gonna go home anytime soon? Or are you just gonna live here with me? Apparently she's just gonna live here with me. Okay, cool. I made a mistake. American Norse for the win. Norse inspired fantasy. Yeah, correct. What do you call that character? It's a good thing I name my blocks sensibly, you know? Starting skill levels. Alright, this is the one that it's going to be deprecated because I'm going to change it. Hey. So maybe we shouldn't change that yet. Before I do the whole groups thing. I think we just do the groups thing first. Yeah. But now I remember. Ha! I am not an idiot. I'm just scatterbrained. I promise. The reason I went here was that I wanted to pick that block up. I need this block. Moo, you're just not going to, are you? No, she's not. She's... well then, one of the few places where Polish people are real. What system do you use to show this in Twitch? I use OBS. OBS Studio on Linux. So this is just a window capture of my Opera browser. And then I have two webcams, so one is on my face and then a green screen behind me, and then I have another webcam, if you look right there, that is filming the Mises. And I just superimpose those on the green screen, generally. But yes. Thank you for the follows. I'm not sure why I didn't get any... Streamlabs, are you drunk? There should have been a thing. Oh no, the browser sources. That's also why the chat isn't showing up. Oh. Sorry about that, because the thing is, I recently upgraded OBS to the Git version, so which is the latest development version. Version, wow, Swedish version. And previously I've been using a plugin, basically a third party plugin, to get browser sources to show up on Streamlabs or on OBS. So basically Streamlabs chat, Streamlabs events, all of these things. And that plugin has been deprecated and is no longer upgraded because there's a built-in version in the new OBS. I just haven't set it up yet. So the chat and everything is gone. I'm sorry. I will fix. I use OBS Live. I would use Streamlabs OBS, but they haven't ported it to Linux yet. So I'm stuck with the bare standard OBS Studio. So I have to do a lot of finagling to get fancy stuff. And now, unfortunately, there is no fancy stuff. So we don't have an amazing Wayne June saying, "Welcome to Lena Loos," when Lorraine dunks him into the cult. Unfortunately. Wait, what does a prenumeration do? Prenumeration, that was a very Swedish word. A subscription gives you access to all the emotes that our channel has, which is at the moment two. And you also get an access to the Patreon area on my Discord server. And also you get like, when I play games where you can have characters, you get a character in the in-game, and a few other boons from being subscribed. Now, I want the skills article. Now, where do we put it though? That's the question. I want this block to be in here. I think we're just gonna put it here. Under here. between, just above the improving with experience. Also going to Witcher. The Witcher was written by a guy in Poland, yes. Improving with experience, that's where we're gonna put it. So we're gonna go row, coal, 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 and row. And then we're gonna have our blurb there, and we're gonna have the block there. Ah, shit. Oh well, it's probably gonna, yeah, it's gonna work anyway. I didn't close the last row though. Whoops. Oh, the Euclid editor supports multi-line typing. It does! How so? You didn't know? You can type on multiple lines. Yes. You didn't know? It's not usually that useful, but it does have that. Oh, yes. So if you have the Euclid editor and you, gonna give myself some space here, and you press one area, then you control click another line. Now you can type in both places. So Euclid is cool. I've never really had any use for that function in particular, but the highlighting is the best part. It makes everything so much easier. Alt drag allows you to box select. That is weird and also kind of cool. I'm not sure how that works yet. I'm gonna have to figure that one out. You can even write more than two lines. Neat. Again, I don't know where I would use that, but that's cool. Where view, that's what I wanted. So, now that we have that, we need a header there. And that's gonna be character starting skills. I can't tell if you're under the thing or if you are in the thing. Also, Lorraine, you didn't answer my question. I demand an answer. This is the wrong one. That's where I'm supposed to be. What are you writing on now? I am trying to... Well, basically, after playtesting a couple of times, we've come to the conclusion that a character really doesn't have enough skills to start out with. You kind of need a few. More. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to sit down and divide my skills into core skills, professional skills, and flavor skills, basically role-playing skills, so that I can more, how do you say, so I can more effectively determine how many skills a character actually needs, because right now you get 10 skills and that's not really enough. Multilines would probably be good with typing BB code, such as the table. That's true. Could be useful for that. You're not wrong. I may have missed the question due to a buffer. The question was, why do you do this? Why do you type two comments? I'm confused because it happens so often too. What was the blurb again? It's in the character article thing. There, that's what I want to. La-da-da-da-da-da. And that's the blurb. Because I forgot a point I wanted to have in the first comment and then I remembered it later. Yeah, and you can't edit comments because I don't know why. This needs to be removed. Hey, what are you doing? just dug her claws into my neck because she wanted to go underneath the thing. That too much though? That is kind of too much. So the character experience thing should be full size.
Okay.
Character experience. This one should be below here. Okay. Now it's time for you to go home. Thank you. Moose has gone home. Oh, so warm with that thing on. Now, this should look better. Yes. In one way or another, I'm gonna have to change this. Because right now, this stat block is hairy bad. Like really, really, really bad. I'm actually going to show you in spite of how much this is going to hurt my soul. It looks good when it's in the article, but editing it, oh boy. Look at this. That's what you have to fill out. That's just, nobody's going to do this. It's useless. What I am going to do is make a way better one. Because right now I have one variable for each of these. I could just make them lists instead, like I've done with everything else. So you just add them with separators, and that would be so much easier. Then you could basically make this one stat, or this one box, this one box, this one box, this one box. And it would be so much easier to fill out. So yeah, I need to fix that because it's it's not great. Oh, you tired? Are you getting cuddled now? Mises are the best pets, just saying. Okay. Now that we fixed that, it is time to take a look at the actual skills themselves. And I'm gonna need the notebook for this. Does anyone know what Void Soda is? Void Soda is what this channel calls channel points. It is something you accumulate from just watching, basically. And you can spend them on different things. I can review your article. You can modify emotes. You can summon a moose, and sing things like that. I just opened World Level. Apparently I have 568 notifications. Oh God in heaven, haven't you been here for a while? Why did you call it Void Soda? It's because of a meme, really. Because I was drinking orange soda once. And when I had it in a glass that was slightly tinted blue, it became the same green as the green screen. So it meant that my soda basically went through everything and looked transparent. And at the time I had a very technical digital background. So we named it Void Soda, and then it became a drink in Cinders of the Cataclysm as well. So Void Soda is just a running gag, basically. I haven't done any world building since mid-December. Oh my God, you burned out? Jesus. I was going to slap the Void Soda article into a chat. I think that's not even existing at this point. Is it? Yeah, it's the work in progress sneak peeks, yes. That is for Patreons only, so that is, it's not a draft, it's a Patreon article, I think. It should be. Published private, yeah. It's for patrons only. Don't want to begin the world cleanups, and I don't know where to start. Hey, that's a mood. Okay, core skills. The thing that everyone always has. The problem is with making core skills is that if you're making core skills, you have to tailor them to your setting, because you ain't gonna have electronics and computers in a medieval setting. So maybe I just shouldn't do that. Ooh, I just had a brilliant idea. I'm going to do the thing that I've been talking about forever. Oh yeah. Oh yes. So, I just had the best idea. Just give me a moment here and I shall see if I can fix something first. Why did you go black? What? Dude, bro? Do that too. And now we can do this. Is this gonna get me copyright striked? No, it's chubby, okay. I have 7 World Emerald Worlds in the same setting, oh goodness. No, I had the brilliant idea, because I had an idea once that I was going to make skills that you can blank check, basically skills that you can roll on no matter if you have them or not. And then you are going to have academic skills that you actually need training to use. You can't just wing it. Because if you don't know how to manage a nuclear reactor, you can't just wing it. So, what we are going to do is going to start separating them up into core skills that can be freely rolled, professional skills, which are academic skills that you actually need, natural and learned skills, yeah, and then we're going to have the flavor skills, which are basically role-playing skills that can be situationally useful, but not necessarily something that you're going to have a lot of use of in a campaign. So, that's what we're gonna do. It's still a lot of worlds, Lena Lose. Hey, you know what? I'm feeling sad without the chat, so I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do this. Where are we gonna put it? We're gonna put it here. Did that not work? Well, I did see it. Briefly. Oh, that's wrong. That's entirely wrong. How do I get void sodas? Some pop up now and then. Yeah, they really do just pop up now and then. That is kind of how they work. Basically, you will, for just watching the stream, you will get a steady tick of void sodas. But in order to engage There are sometimes gift-wrapped void sodas that show up that you can click. So if you're here and if you're chatting and interacting, you get more void sodas. That's how Twitch designed it. And hey! I fixed the chat! Whee! We have chat. Now we can remove the old chat. Remove? What else do we need? We need Streamlabs, because that damn thing needs to be here. 1800, 400. New browser source. Slobs. Subs. 1800, 600. 60. That's just gonna be middle of the screen because it's a massive thing. There you go. Is the screen version of chats a touch hard to read? Yeah. Sorry. Isn't the purple on faint black rather difficult to make out? Yeah, it is. I'm going to fix that eventually. But, yeah. Streamlabs. Also, it requires spare time, which I don't have. But I'm going to fix it, I promise. I will eventually fix it. Actually, I might be able to fix it immediately, now that I think about it. Are you serious? Did you log me out? Bruh. Streamlabs, please. Cooperate with me. Now, if I do this, and then do this, chat's gonna refresh, and every chat that shows up from now on is going to be more readable, hopefully. That's at least my goal. The community challenge stopped at 80% for as long as I can remember. It looks funny. Yeah. The thing is, the community challenges just never really got anywhere. Why is it still purple, pink purple thing? Now I'm confused. 1800, 400. Remove. 1800, 400. Bruh. Isn't pink the purple the color of COTC? Yes, it is. It's absolutely. Oh god. It is the color of COTC, but I mean, it doesn't matter if it's the color of COTC if it's unreadable. Good night, Rock. Have a good one. Sorry, I got distracted by Streamlabs. I didn't mean to. Hey, look, I did it. I think. Yes, I did it. Is that more readable? I just changed to another color just rapidly so you could actually read the damn thing. Oh, good. I did it. Right, skills. Jesus, I'm the ADHDist today. Being a game developer and having ADHD is freaking fantastic. It makes things a lot harder. So, we're gonna go to stat blocks. And we are going to go to skills. Communication. We're going to look at all the core skills. Acrobatics, absolutely. Animal handling, is that truly a core skill? Yeah, you could have a natural hand with animals, yes. Sure, ADHD makes things harder, but it lets you be super creative and stuff. Yes, when you're not paralyzed, obviously. Athletics, bluffing, disguise, survival, intimidation, language, lockpicking. Language? Yes. First aid, perception, persuasion, riding, seduction, streetwise, stealth, urban survival, handguns, submachine guns, rifles, shotguns, assault rifles, light energy weapons. I'm gonna say these are not core weapons. Or, actually, anyone can pick up a laser gun and shoot it. Throwing electronics. Electronics? That's not a core skill. Computers is not a core skill. Digital forgery is not a core skill. Mechanics is not a core skill. Or is it? Here's the question. You can dabble in mechanics. You can dabble with electronics. Can you dabble with computers? And digital forgery is definitely not going to be a core skill. That's just a big nope. Electronics? Yeah, sure. Advanced computer skills such as programming, modification, usage, or repair of computer interfaces. Most computer software is friendly and do not require a check for skill, but modifying software, interacting with software is non... No, that's not a core skill. Would CD10 work for an alternate Earth with magic? If yes, do I need to pay for anything to use it in my world? The answer to the first question is yes, it would. The answer to the second question is no. CD10 is free to use. CD10 Core, which is the core system, is free to use. That does not include some advanced features. So magic is the ability system, and that is unfortunately currently being alpha tested, and that is paid for, so that is Patreon only right now. But the rest of the system is absolutely free to use. So this is not a core skill. No, it's not. Digital forgery is not a core skill. I need to explain these somewhere later. Mechanics, you can technically dabble in mechanics. Probably not going to go well, but you can. Will the system for magic be added to core in the future? No, it is one of the parts of CD10 Advanced, together with several other things that make CD10 Core a little more complex. So no, you have the skills, you have everything, except... Actually, I have an article for this. Give me a second.
You have an article for this.
There was someone who asked, when you click edit, does it open in a new tab? Well, would sending an email count as dabble electronics? No, it wouldn't. When I click on edit, does it open in a new tab? Yes, they do. Because I hold control when I'm clicking. I mean... Since it's free to use, you can read through it and make up your mind if you want to use it or not. And, I mean, eventually there's going to be a PDF that it's going to be a one-time purchase. Right now, during testing, it is paid for, because if you want to participate in the test, I need to interact with you a lot, which takes a lot of time, so I need to be paid for it. but eventually there's going to be a one-time purchase of Advanced as well. What was I going with this? I was going to check something. The road to 1.0? Road to... Oh, it's in COTC, I think. Control new tab. Correct. Road to... There it is. So... What did it do? What is not in CD10 Core? Complex combat mechanics. So... Auto fire, basically these all exist in one way or another, but they're not the complex version. Psionics, cybernetics, magic, mutations, biotech. Those are the big things that are missing from CD10 Core. And then there are small things like infection from injuries, bleeding. Off the top of my head, why is this so hard to remember just off the top of my head? CD10 Advanced. Injuries. Situational injuries like fire, cold, starvation, exhaustion, diseases and poisons, stress, which is basically long time shock, bleeding and infection, and then the ability system, which is magic, cybernetics, mutations. It's basically a framework where you can build an ability system around. So it's not like this is one version that you have to use. It's these are rules and mechanics for you to build your own magic system. But could I use core and home rules and magic rules? Yes, you could. I always forget that the world codes is there. Yeah, the world codex is like, it's not something I think about a lot, but it is here indeed. Right. But yes, you can absolutely use CD10 core and then homebrew whatever you want on top of it. And it wouldn't be that difficult, really. It wouldn't be the system I designed, but it would could work. And CD10 is definitely a system where you are encouraged to do your own stuff. I mean, we literally have, in the skills article, you have this. Creating your own skills. Because if there's a skill that you need that doesn't exist, make it up. It's the same with traits and spells and everything. It is kind of a system that you buy once and then you do whatever you want with it. Or you use the core system and you don't have to buy it at all. Heavy weapons. Investigation. Hunting, archery, crossbow, dual weapons, balance, blah, blah, blah. Bastard weapons, heavy pole arms, sling. Okay, cool. Cool. Now we're going to look through communication. Have you heard of Chronopia? Yes, I have. I've never played it. I've never read it. But I've heard of it. Oh, right. These are also core skills. Entertaining. It's a flavor skill, so the flavor skills are probably going to be free rolls as well. Etiquette communication. So we need to make a tag called create new folder. We're gonna call these professional skills. No, academic. What do we? I need a good word for a skill that you cannot use without having studied it first. Basically, you have to learn this skill to use it. I would like to call it academic, but that would kind of rule out practical skills. Trained, learned. Yeah, but every skill is going to be trained or learned at some point. A professional skill is kind of, yeah, I agree. Professional skills kind of do fit there. Hi, Emily. How are you doing? I hope you're doing well. So, are there any here that you need to train? No. Well, therapy. No, you can dabble in therapy. The communication skills do not have any, basically. Crafts. I don't think there's anything here. A lot of these kind of do need to be trained. You can't just wing it with these. Or can you? Yeah, you can. You can try and make a chair without knowing how to make a chair. It's gonna look like crap, but you can. Yeah, you can do all of these. It's gonna end up terrible, but you can do them. All right, fine. Dark shadows? Why are these here? Oh, fair. Fey-blooded should probably move to another world. Longsword? Why is that here? Alright. So, Fey-blooded is going to move to Dark Shadows. It is in Dark Shadows. It's a trait. Why is it here? Why is that in this list? I am so confused. Also, whoops. Back off. I don't know if you could smith your own armor though. I mean, you could try, that's the thing. You could try. Am I stupid? Yes, I am. This is a longsword, which is an item. It should not be here. It should be in Dark Shadows. Why is it here? And weapons. Try to strap a pair of rocks around yourself. Yep, armor. There you go. You did it. And here's the question. Can you delete this? Yes, you can. Cool. Now we need to go into firearms, and I would guess all of these are... Anyone can use a weapon. Although I would argue that energy weapons might be more tricky, but no, anyone can point a weapon and pull the trigger. Might not hit anything, but you can. Administration. Architecture is definitely not a core skill, that's a professional skill. Calculus is a professional skill. Photography, chemistry. Rock solid armor. Correct. Now you're talking. Heraldry is not something you can just wing it. You kind of need to know that. Herbalism, everybody knows a little about it. So I guess those work. Literacy is definitely a trained skill. Medicine, surgery. Right. Architecture, professional skills. Professional. Calculus. I need the comma there too. Surgery sounds professional. Yeah. Very. Janet pun points. I hate you. heraldry. Yep. Literacy. Medicine. Dang it. Surgery. Go. Now we have those. We're gonna go now to maneuvers. These are probably all going to be core skills. Brawl, crossbow, dancing, dexterity, dual weapons, heavy one-handed weapons, heavy pole arms, light pole arms, lock picking. I am tempted to put lock picking in trained skills because you really can't just fumble a lock up unless it's a terrible lock without knowing how to do it. Is it lockpicking if I take a hammer to the lock? No, that is not lockpicking. Lockpicking sort of assumes that the lock is usable when you're done. So this is going to be a professional skill. Heavy pole, light pole arm, lockpicking, melee weapons, blah, 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 polar machine, riding, skiing, sling, stealth. Swimming, throwing. Swimming depends on the setting. In some settings, it might be a professional skill. Anyway. Professional skills. Technology. Computers. It's not computer use, it's advanced usage. So digital forgery, driving is not something you need to train. You can wing it. Electronics, mechanics. Piloting, on the other hand. Flying something? Can you just wing it with piloting? I'm tempted to say no. Computers, professional. It's in a modern setting, riding is a professional skill level as well. Hey, I live in a modern world. I can ride a horse. Not good, but I can ride a horse without having trained it. You can always start flying. It's the landing that would be crazy. It's usually the landing that is the hard part, yes. You are not wrong. You are in fact correct. Why is this a core skill? Go away. Professional. Mechanics. You can kind of dabble in mechanics. Yeah. Piloting. I'm gonna need you to have a professional skill on that one. Well, you will always land. No? Landing implies that the airplane or whatever you're flying is usable afterwards. Kind of like lockpicking. I'm sure we can wing it with piloting. Oh my god.
Have I mentioned I hate you?
Athletics is willpower, apparently. Why is that not in maneuvers? Because it's more about stamina than actual coordination. Fair? I'm okay with that. Drinking, fishing, hunting, investigation, perception, survival, tracking, urban survival, withstand torture. Sure, all of these work. So there's not actually that many. We're gonna look into crafts again. So armor smithing, blacksmithing. No, blacksmithing, I would argue, is not a professional skill. Landing is just a controlled crash. I played Flight Simulator. I'd never get a real airplane off the ground. Probably, I wouldn't even be able to start a real airplane. It's legitimately complicated. Okay, Nina, are you in chat? I need to ask you a thing. Bow, you can't just wing a bow. Yes, you can. Terrible bow. Cobbling. Cobbling is making shoes? Oh, the cobbler repairs shoes. Right. Coopering is making barrels. I'm in chat. Okay, cool. Bookbinding. Professional skill, or can you just wing it? Cordage and cordwaining sounds like the same thing. Make ropes, strings, and twines. Okay. Cobbling is shoes. That's professional. Actually, it's gonna be both. Flavor skills and professional. Professional skill, yeah. Bookbinding is good pressure. Cordwainer is the one who makes shoes. Alright, it's the one who makes the fancy shoes. I got it. That's definitely professional. I think it's a bit hard to wing bookbinding if you have no idea what you're doing. Yeah, I kinda got that feeling too, so.
Why did I end up here? I'm supposed to be here.
Bookbinding, professional. Covered to casting, cobbling, coppering, cordage, cordwaining, dyeing. Dyeing, engraving, you can try to engrave something, it's not gonna end well. Fletching, you kinda can do that. It's like sewing, but with paper. Fair. Gloss making, I'm tempted to say you can't wing either, because you need to actually know stuff about temperature and stuff. Book binding is professional. Paper and glue, and many, many, many extra steps. Dyeing, I'm gonna say, is a professional skill. Glass making is a professional skill. I mean, you can try your way forward and try to learn, but that involves studying. ink is professional. It's a precise science, yes. Locksmithing. Shipwrighting. Shoemaking you can kind of wing. Just making very simple shoes. Ink making. Glass is usually an expensive material because it's a precise science. I thought you said that dyeing is a professional skill. Yeah, it is. I mean, come on. It takes talent to dye. Shipwrighting. Professional. Stone cutting, tanning. Yeah. Wainwrighting, I think. Weaponsmithing, definitely. Weaving, though. I mean, you can make a terrible piece of cloth as long as you have a loom. If you don't have a loom, then weaving is a professional skill. Whitesmithing. Tanning. Yeah, I'm gonna say that's a professional one, actually. Tanning is hard. I guess you could wing simple weaving. Yeah. Loom. Nay, loom. L-O-O-M. Wainwright is designing carts and wagons. That's a professional skill. Weaponsmithing, definitely. Whitesmithing, definitely. Why do I keep hearing things wrong? I don't know, you're bad at English, just like me. So the combination is terrible. Submarine operator. Submarine operation. That's gonna be in Cinders of the Cataclysm, actually. Skills. Gods. Need a frame for weaving. That's true. Okay, so we did all that. Now we just need a list of skills. We're gonna do the last one, which is core skills, combat skills. We're gonna make this a call 3, I think. Wait. Hold up. I could totally wing commanding a submarine. This goes down, right? glove. Oh, there we go. I see, okay. Fine. Not sure I'm okay with that. I'm gonna go with examples. Then we're gonna do this. Core skills, and then we're gonna have professional skills. Professional skills are skills you cannot perform a blank check on. You have to have trained the skill to at least +1 before you can attempt a skill check on it. And then we have Tagged Blocks Professional. Zablep. Cool. Now we can also do this. A row. Call. Would you please cooperate with me, throat? You're not being nice right now. All skills. Here follows a complete list of all skills in CD10, not counting skills created by other creators in other worlds. The article you showcase now is for patrons, yes? This one, core skills, no. This is a part of CD10 Core. Lorraine can probably drop a link for you if you want to look at it. Because she usually does that. Unless I catch her in a moment where she's away and can't do that. There you go. Core skills are skills that a character does not necessarily have to have. Core skills are skills that a character does not necessarily have to have learned in order to use. These skills can have a... Hey, Havoc, you hungry? Can be performed with a blank check if you have no value. Athletics, brawl, dexterity, disguise, persuasion, language. Yes. Combat skills only. Might just be me. The white example text is a bit difficult to see. Might just be me, though. The white example text? This? That is probably because it's on stream. The stream isn't the best resolution. But it is easier to read in the article itself. But I also think that this font is a little bit too small, because I think the CSS is broken at the moment. I need to fix the CSS. This is supposed to be bigger. Hey guys, how is everyone? What a giggle. A friend of mine just posted a pic on Facebook she took of herself. Apparently on Sky Cinema, the Goonies is listed as offensive. What? Nani? Yeah, the CSS is borked because I just recently updated the CSS. Let's actually check that. What is this called? It is staff block, skill block info. Yeah, the font size is being overridden. Okay. Skill block info box. Font size 1.2 EM. Why does that not work? It always did work before. Invalid value? Why? The Goonies? Yeah, it's a movie. Popular from the 80s? Yes. Yeah. What am I doing wrong here? Is it being overridden by anything else? No, then it would be dashed. Why is this an improper... Headers? Hold on, wait. Oh, I see. There's something fishy with my CSS. I see. That's what breaks it. 1.2 EM. There you go. Fixed it. Now the font is the size it's supposed to be. Thought it looked small. You're right. There's a bug in my CSS. What does EM stand for in CSS? I use PX. It's a relative. If I remember correctly, it is a relative size based on line spacing. So 1.2 EM would be a font size of 1.2 lines. So instead of using PIX, which is a hard-coded thing that doesn't care about your line spacing, EM is relative to your line spacing. That's what I think it is, if I remember correctly. So if you have very large line spacing, 1.2 EM is going to be very much larger than if you have a small line spacing. Elements font size. The EM means my parent element's font size. Oh, okay, I see. So if you have nested classes that depend on each other, then it inherits the font size of its parent, and then it makes it bigger. Like, so 1.2 EM would be what? 20% bigger? Right, my bad. So it's not line spacing, it's the parent element. Is EM better than PIX? It entirely depends on where you use it. EM has the potential to either make things a lot easier for you because you can change a lot of fonts at the same time if you have nested classes. So it's like, I need this to be a little bit bigger, and then you can change all of them by just changing the core value. But it could also, on the other hand, be that if you have EM everywhere and you change one font size, everything suddenly changes and you didn't want that. So it kind of depends on your use case. It can be better. I use it sometimes. Not always. Okay, so that gives us the core skills, and now I need to figure out how many skills. Okay, players. And that would be Nina, Hefe, and Lorraine. If you would just straight up pick a number of skills you would like to have for your character, how many would you like to have? And I mean as a starting character, starting out. Is 15 too many? I think so. My idea was kind of to add to add 2 or 3 plus 2 skills and 1 or 2 plus 4 skills, maybe 1 plus 6, but I'm not sure. I think another plus 6 would be too powerful to starting out. So 1 more plus 4 and maybe 3 or 4 plus 2. To 15 personally, yeah. What is defined as skills now? Are strong and stuff skills? Oh, right, you are correct. Yes, I should add those. Athletics is your strength, so yes, and dexterity is your agility. I need an agility thing. They're gonna be maneuver skills. We have acrobatics, which is your dexterity, and then we have athletics, which is your strength. We also need our smarts. What is that going to be? Logic? Reasoning? Reason? Astuteness? So yes. Athletics is your strength, and Acrobatics is your dexterity. Charm. Do we have one of those in communication? Etiquette? No, not really. Seduction. Because if you need to add strong and stuff like that, while it's backstory skills, then you need more than just background skills. Yeah, I agree. Perception is a standard skill, maybe not a smart equivalent. No, perception is just how attentive you are. How good you are noticing things. So, we need a smirt and we need a charm. We don't need knowledge, because that's based on your skills already. It's how many skills do you have. That's knowledge. You had 10 skills total before. Yeah. You had 1 at plus 6, you had 3 at plus 4, and then the rest, which is 5. 6. 5, 6? 6. At plus 2. And plus 2 isn't that mighty, so you can easily add in way more plus 2s. It is the 4 and 6 that I'm hesitant. I don't think I want to add more plus 6s, because that's going to be an achievement, because that's where you actually start getting really good at what you're doing. The 2 and 4 are more situational flavor skills, so maybe add one or more 4. And the rest as 2. I think. But I'm gonna keep the traits the same, because I noticed when I made NPCs that plus 6 is really strong. I just realized I have 215,687 words in 486 articles, and most of it needs edit. You're gonna have a lot of fun then. Yeah. Why do you refer to the GM as she and not them? Mostly because when I wrote these rules, I had not really been exposed to non-binary and trans people that prefer them. But I had encountered a lot of women who had been ostracized and basically told that TTRPGs are not for you. So I wrote them and tried to make a statement that girls can be GMs. And that's also kind of why I kept it, because women are still very slighted in the TTRPG space. So I made the player he and the GM, or keeper as we call them, a female. That's why. So why she and not he? That's why. Because women don't get the space they need in TTRPGs. So I kind of want to emphasize that girls can also be GMs and play role-playing games. And besides, everyone else uses he, so I kind of wanted to make a statement. You should come to Poland and tell the bookstore company Empik that. For them, TTRPGs are toys for boys. Yep, I know. And that's kind of what we're living in. So if it says she, maybe it can inspire some girl somewhere to pick up role-playing games. No, I did see it. Nina, I did see your answer. And I'm pondering it. Now the question is though, do I want to remake this now? Quick question, but was it Streamlabs OBS you use? No, I use OBS Studio, which is the bare bones one, because I'm on Linux and Streamlabs OBS does not support Linux yet. But if you're on Windows, I recommend Streamlabs OBS because it's just better. It's much easier to use and it has more built-in functions that are really useful. So more plugins and stuff. So OBS Streamlabs is really good. But I use the bare bones one because that's the only option I have. Because Linux life! Personally, I love having females in TTRPG games. It brings a different atmosphere to the game, which is great, usually less likely to go all hack and slash and have a proper balanced, enjoyable game. I agree. My own group that I played with before the pandemic, we generally had more women than men in the group for most of it. But I think in the end, we were entirely balanced. We had like three guys and three girls, if I'm not wrong. Nina can correct me on that one, but I think so. And I learned that that is kind of rare. Most groups are mostly men. I think you have more women than men in the closed beta as well. Yes, that's correct. I do. Oh, well, not if you count... Yes. Yes, I do. I have one more girl than boys. Okay, so... I'm gonna make a note right... not here. Wait. What just happened? What is that? Huh? I don't even know what happened. Well, that was weird. It was really weird. Okay. Five players sometimes, and then three girls, two boys, sans GM, or four players most of the time, then we were equal. Yeah. Okay, do I want to do this now? No, I want to remake this first. Because this piece of shit needs to go.
It needs to die.
And become much better. So I'm gonna add that to my to-do list. I'm gonna add... I'm gonna add a new section, World Anvil. Add a task, remake starting skills block. I'm gonna make that a relatively high priority because I need to do it. And when do we do it? Let's do it on Thursday. Let's do it next stream. Just remake the starting block so we can actually get working on the skills. My group is also odd in that depending on campaign, we're either split men, women, or we have more women than men. But also we have three GMs in my group. Wow. Well, technically we do too, because Nina ran a game, Sam ran games, and I ran games. So we have three GMs too. Although I'm kind of the default GM. I run most of the games and have been the core of the group forever. But I think Sam was the reason we started playing together, because he pulled the group together and started... got us playing. Actually, he started. We started playing Year Zero with him before we started playing Selenia. All right, and we also need skills. Make sure we have strength, dex, con, int, charisma, ka skills. That's going to be a high priority, and we're also going to do that on the next stream if we can make the starting skills block. We're also going to do this, that stream, if we can. We did this. That's done. Separate core skills from flavor skills. We did that. Nice. We're getting somewhere. Hey, Harmony. All right. I think that's about it for today. Because I started late, so I unfortunately need to leave you. Now, the question is, it's Tuesday. Does anyone stream after me? I think so. Kahuna should be up, right? Red! Kahuna is up. So I'm gonna throw you over to Kahuna, and I will see you on Thursday, where we continue this work and actually get more stuff done. We didn't really get much actual stuff done today, but we had a good discussion today where stuff happened. I actually got some groundwork done so I can start actually making changes. So thank you for today. Sorry for being late, but I will see you on Thursday, and we'll hopefully have a normal stream on Thursday, and same time as always, which is 2 hours back from now, but on Thursday. I will see you then. Toodles.